Hi students, welcome to our class. Today let's move with the textbook exercises. Integers already we started and now exercise 1.3. Let's see our textbook problem. First question.
Yeah.
Find each of the product. Okay. First one is we have A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. Some problems are written from question number 1. First one, here 3 is positive integer and negative 1 is negative integer. Okay, one positive integer and one negative integer we have. How we will find product? Yes, just multiply the numbers as a whole and put the negatives there if there is only one negative. So let's see, 3 multiply with 3, you can directly write answer as 3 and there is one negative, so you just give negative symbol. Okay. Correct, negative sign you have to give here. See the second one. Negative 1, this is negative number and this is positive number. What does it mean? If one is negative and another one is positive, just multiply both the numbers. 1 multiply with 225, you will get 225. Then, you will get 225. Then, if there is only one negative, you have to put that negative sign with your result. So, here one negative sign that you put with your result. So your answer is negative 225. And the next one, let's see. Negative 21, negative 30. Here both the numbers are negative. You have both negative integers. So how you can find the answer? Just take the numbers, multiply and write your answer first. Okay. First, 21 and 30 you have. 21 and 30. These are the numbers we have. Just multiply and write the answer first. So you will get the answer. That answer you write here. 63 you will get. Okay. With this 63 I put the 0 also. 630. 630 is your answer. And see, negative and negative. You have 2 negative. If both the numbers have the negatives, yes, your result will be positive. So you can write here positive 630. Here also you have 2 negative numbers, negative 316 and negative 1. Both are negative integers. So what we can do here? Directly multiply both the numbers. Multiply with 1 only do first. Any number multiply with 1, you will get the number itself. So, you can write here 360. Now, both are negative integers. So, both the negatives multiply and your answer will be positive. So, your answer is positive 360. So, it may not be mentioned by 360 with positive. Either you can write plus 360 or directly write whatever. Both are same. Then the next one, E. Negative 15, 0, negative 80. Multiplying 3 numbers. Here you took 2 integers. Here 3 integers we have. So either big one of them is 0. So any integer multiply with 0, your product is 0. So directly you can write here your answer is 0. Next problem, F. Negative 1 multiply negative 2 multiply negative 3 multiply with 4, like that. Here how many integers you have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 integers you have in total. See, here you have 3 integers, here 4 integers. Okay. So, whatever be, how many integers, whatever be, what you have to do is, just make a pair of 2's. So, it will be simple for you. So, first of all, we can take these 2 as a pair. And the next you are considering these 2 as next pair. So, the first 2 integers multiply and write that answer. And you can put this negative, you can put this multiplication, then third and fourth answer like that. Here, negative 1 multiply with negative 2, what is you got? 1 into 2 is 2, negative into negative is positive. So you can write here positive 2 means 2. Then multiply. So write multiply, 2 multiply. Here, negative 3 multiply with 4. Negative 3 multiplied with 4 is 3 4s are 12. Negative 12. So, write here negative 12. Okay. So which is equal to what is the answer? 2 multiplied with 12 is 24. So your answer is negative 24. Why negative here? What is negative integer? That's why we can write here negative 24. Is it clear? See, now we studied some problems to find the product. It means the multiplication. Check question number 2. Here, verify. Verify this problem. Let's see the question. 18 multiplied. Here in bracket 7 plus negative 3. Okay. And on the RHS side, this is LHS and the right side is RHS. RHS side 18 multiplied with 7 plus 18 multiplied with negative 3. You see here, do you remember what is the property? This property, name of the property, what's that? Let's see here, 18 is outside, here 18 is distributed to both. So what is the property? Yes, distributive property. 18 multiplied with 7 and 18 multiplied with negative 3. Like that, distributing and writing here. So this is the property name is distributive property. So here it is given that both the sides are equal. But we have to check. Yes, we have to verify that both are same. So first of all, write LHS side and find the answer. Next, RHS side. And that answer also, then if both the answers are equal, you can verify that hand. Yes, it is true, like that. Here, both the answers will be same because you have distributive property. Remember that. Okay. So now let's check the LHS side. Okay. LHS. LHS. Let's say first we can do. So first of all, we are writing this same. LHS side, we are writing directly. 18 multiply with 7 plus negative 3. Okay. This LHS we are doing and finding that answer. This side only. So what answer you will get? 18 multiply here. In this bracket, what you get? Answer. Addition, subtraction. Switch to? Yes. Both addition and subtraction switch to? Subtraction 0. Negative sign. So 7 is the negative 3. What is 7 minus 3? 7 negative 3. 7 minus 3 is 4. Okay. So here you will get 4. So 18 multiplied with 4. So what is the answer? 18 multiplied with 4. 5. Written right here. So let's check 18 multiplied with 4. What will be the answer? You will get the answer as 72. 8 4s are 32. 3. 1 4s are 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. So your final answer will be 72. Okay. Clear, LHS side. So let's check the RHS side and let's find whether both are same. RHS. The next is RHS. Now you have to find 18. This side. First of all, RHS you write here. 18 multiplied with 7 plus 18 multiplied with negative 3. First step is write the RHS. This RHS you write here. And the next we are finding each product. See? In this bracket, you have two sessions. You have two parts. First part is 18 multiplied with 7. This is the first part and this is the second part. In between, you are doing addition. Okay, 18 multiplied with 7. Find the answer. You will get 126. Okay, that 126 you can write here. 126. Then addition. Here, 18 multiplied with negative 3. So first of all, 18 multiplied with 3 you can do and find. Have you got 54? Yes, that is the answer, 54. That 54 right here with the negative because you have negative 3. Okay, so and next step you can write 126 and this positive and negative switch to negative 54. Okay, clear. Now what is the answer? Just subtract both 126 minus 54, subtract and write the answer. 126 and 54, subtract and write that answer. So you will get the answer as 72. Okay, so let's check both the answers, both LHS and RHS. Check both. Here LHS, what answer you got LHS? Yes, here LHS. Here LHS is 72. This is LHS and what is the RHS? RHS also you got 72. So both are you got as same. So we can conclude that LHS is equal to RHS. It means, yes, have you verified? Is it correct? Yes, it's true and has verified. So you can write, it is verified. And this is correct because you have the property. What is the property name? Yes, your property is distributing property. So whatever be the problem, you can do on the same method. First of all, find LHS, then RHS. If both are same, you can write hence it is verified. Okay, clear? Question number 3. Here you have, question number 3 have 1 and 2. Two parts we have. First one, for any integer a, what is negative 1 multiplied with a equal to? So you are choosing an integer a. What is negative 1 multiplied with a? If you have a, you have negative 1 multiplied with a. What is the answer? So any integer you are multiplying with negative 1. First of all, what you have to do? This 1 without this sign. This 1 multiplied with a, you will get a. And put the sign, this negative. Because here this is positive and this is negative integer. So put this negative. So you will get negative a. So any integer a, then what is negative 1 multiplied with a equal to? So negative 1 multiplied with any integer, you will get negative integer. Negative of that integer. Which integer you chose, negative of that you will get. Okay, clear? Okay. Now next one is, determine integer whose product with the negative 1 is. So we have the integers like this. The first one is negative 22. Next one is 37. Next one is 0. And you are finding the product with the negative 1. That's also simple. Here you have the question negative 22. Finding the product with the negative 1. So what will be your answer? Negative 22, finding product with the negative 1. So just directly multiply 22 with 1. You will get 22. And negative multiply with negative. Both the negative, your answer will be yes, positive. Plus 22. Is it needed? Yes. If you are directly write 22 also, that is same. Okay. So now B. Here 37. Find the product with the negative 1. So 37 multiply with the negative 1. 37 multiply with the negative 1. What is the answer? Yes. Simply multiply the numbers as fold and put the negative sign. 37 multiply with 1 is 37 and put the sign negative. The next one is your number is 0 itself. So how to find the product with negative 1? Yes, here you can do. Here your number is 0. You are finding product with negative 1. So what we can do? See, any number, we know any number multiplied with 0 is 0 itself. So here directly you can write 0 because any number multiplied with 0, you will get the answer 0. Then we did 3 problems and find the product with negative 1. Is it clear? Okay. So now in this video we discussed 3 problems. Question number 1, 2, 3 of exercise 1.3. So all of you do once again play back and understand all the problems well. Write all the problems neatly in your notebook. That's all about our today's class. In the next video, we will continue this exercise 1.3 remaining questions. Until then, bye.